Alright, how's it going, guys? Today we're going to be talking about the top 5 mods that you should do for your GTI. And if you couldn't tell, I'm actually in my new setup. If you've watched any of my previous videos, I've actually been filming out of my old closet, but now I have my own office, so hopefully more content comes out, more quality, because I'm not in a little closet. But anyways, guys, let's get right into the video. Today we're going to be talking about top 5 mods you should do for your GTI. With the GTI platform having minor changes, you know, from Mark 5 to now Mark 7.5, I believe that these mods can be applied to basically any single generation of GTI. And actually, take that back, I would say these apply to Mark 4 to the newest generation. So with me now owning a Mark 5 GTI that I picked up about a month ago now, I've just been having a blast. I really love the car, and I just love everything about it. The looks, the stock power, the handling, you know, the interior, everything has been fantastic. But with that being said, my car is completely stock, and so I've been really looking into, you know, modding and which avenue I should go down and what things I should do to my car to make it go faster. And so with that being said, these are the things I found which should be your first 5 priorities when modding your car. And if you guys have any other modding suggestions, make sure you let me know down below, not just for myself, but for other people who want to mod their GTI. All right, guys, and the first thing I would recommend to anyone who purchases a stock GTI is to instantly go get a tune. So with the turbo platform that the GTI has, the tune is the best bang for buck thing you can do for power. It is just unbelievable. You know, whether it's, you know, Cobb, whether it's APR, or whether it's, you know, Unitronic, they just had the best bang for buck power, whether that's stage 1, stage 2, or stage 3. Even if you just bought, just say your Mark 7 GTI, you rolled off the lot, I would recommend going to your nearest APR dealer and getting that stage 1 tune, which requires no mods. But the power upgrades are just insane. Obviously, the tune takes advantage of the turbo platform and just gives you optimal power from, you know, your stock platform. So for example, my FSI engine within my 2008 GTI, if I were to go get the stage 1 tune right now with no modifications, just the tune, which costs approximately $600 US, I think it costs around 900 Canadian where I'm from, it would give me approximately 40 horsepower and 50 foot-pounds of torque just based off the tune. So if you're looking to get more power of your car, this is definitely the first place to start. So if you watch any of my previous, you know, top modification videos in the past, I always recommend is to go get a good wheel setup. I usually say that's the number one thing you should do. However, with GTI, I do believe it's a bit different. So for number 2, I believe you should go get a solid wheel setup. You know, so a really solid wheel setup, specifically the tire, you know, that will drastically change many things, many characteristics of your car, whether that, you know, that's handling, braking, acceleration. You know, tires help so much, or maybe you just want better fuel economy. You know, there's so many things that a tire can help, and getting a really solid tire setup, just say Michelin Pilot Super Sports, will drastically change the way your car handles and brakes and the things that I just listed. So for number 2, a solid wheel setup. So for number 3, you know, a lot of people don't necessarily recommend this at first, but come on, a cold air intake should be a priority on, you know, basically most, you know, turbo cars. And whether you think that's ricer or not, I think it is great to have. It not only helps your engine breathe better, well, first of all, you know, how much does it cost to replace an air filter on a GTI? You know, I think my Volkswagen dealership, they charge about $50 per air filter, which is just outrageous. So just alone, if you were to buy aftermarket, just say can and intake, you're going to save your money in the long term by not having to buy that pricey Volkswagen part. Because, of course, you can just, you know, either just clean yourself, use intake cleaner, or replace it aftermarket online, which will be a lot cheaper. But who doesn't want to hear turbo noise? This is the point of this mod. Who does not want to hear turbo noises? It lets your turbo have more, you know, airflow, and it's just good for a turbo vehicle, and it's just good to make you smile because you're going to hear that turbo spew and that turbo blow off without having a full blow-off valve. Number 4. Okay, number 4, I'm going to say, is a full, you know, exhaust system, whether that's a cat back, whether that's a full turbo back, whether that's just the downpipe, whether that's a cat delete, you know, muffler delete, getting more sound, getting more airflow from a turbo engine is not the worst thing in the world. Some vehicles, if you were to put a full exhaust on it, would you actually lose power because of back pressure. However, with the turbo platform that a GTI has, that is a non-existent issue. Having a turbo back exhaust really increases your airflow, and it makes your, you know, your car happier. You can never have too much, airflow on a turbo car. You know, it's just great. And also, you'll get a great exhaust tone with the GTI. And you'll see decent performance, especially if you do go for the full turbo back exhaust. All right, and number five, and honestly, this is kind of controversial, but it is, in my opinion, the least important out of this list. However, if depending on who you are, you might view it as the most important, and that is a suspension setup. So whether that's just, lowering springs or coilovers or, whatever you want to do, roll bars, whatever. A suspension setup will help you drastically. If you're one of those people that love to go around corners, especially where I live, there's actually not that many corners. I live in Alberta, Canada, which is known as like the Texas of the North. There's not a lot of mountains. There's not a lot of twisty, bendy roads, unfortunately. But when there is, I really love to take advantage of it. So for me, I would not necessarily prioritize my suspension, but for others, some people love the aesthetics of a lowered car, and I don't blame you. The one thing that a GTI has is a really great suspension setup. It's super comfortable, really great dampening, but again, it has a really great balance of comfortability and performance. So for number five is a suspension setup. If you were to get, that lowered slam GTI, you're definitely, taking away from the comfortability. So that, it just depends on who you are, but a suspension setup for most people is a great way to go. Anyways, guys, that's my top five list for GTI mods. More to come in the future, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye.